I will answer what I can. My life.
Yes, General? Sorry, General, I'm flat out. Something else I can...
Something up? All right, what did you want to know? Yeah, that's a surprise. Did he say I owed him credits too?
I'm as Atton will ever be. And whoever your trusted informant is, he's right. I did show up on Nar Shaddaa during the Jedi Civil War, along with a lot of other refugees.
No, because you're asking about it. If I wanted to tell you anything, I would have come and told you. Anything else? Is this an interrogation? If so, you're terrible at it, especially for an ex-Jedi, or whatever you are. Why don't you just crawl in my head and try to dig out whatever you're looking for rather than asking about it? You know what? I helped you get off, Paragus. If I hadn't been there, you wouldn't have even gotten off the administration level. I'm trying to help you. I don't know why I'm bothering. Yeah, well, I still helped you. Sort of. Maybe you shouldn't look a free Ronto in the mouth before you buy it. You know what? Not once have I asked you about the Mandalorian Wars. Not once.
I heard about Duxon. Everyone has. I heard about Serico, and I sure as hell know about Malachor 5.
What makes you think you've got the right to interrogate me on anything? You've got plenty of lives to answer for. All you Jedi do. How did you even live with yourself after Malachor? Is that why you went back to the Jedi Council? Hoping they'd kill you? Wasn't it? Maybe you thought they'd forgive you. Sure, you might have thought they'd execute you. But Jedi don't kill, do they? At least not their prisoners. Maybe you were counting on it when you went back in chains. So you got off easy. You were exiled, brushed under the cargo ramp. Another dirty little Jedi secret. I'll tell you. All those Jedi at Malachor? They deserved it. Every last one of them.
Because Jedi lie, and they manipulate, and every act of charity or kindness they do, you can drag it out squirming into the light and see it for what it is. The galaxy doesn't need Jedi arrogance or Jedi hypocrisy anymore. At least the Sith are honest about what they're killing for. The Jedi are pacifists, except in times of war. They're teachers, except when it comes to telling their students the truth. And when they save you, it's only so you can suffer more. Whatever, just leave me alone. I don't know why I'm wasting my time with you anyway.
Well, don't get too attached to me. I don't like it. It's because I'm a deserter. It's what I do. Served in both of them. Against the Mandalorians, before and after Revan, and again, when Revan declared war on the Jedi. I did, up until the Republic officers began to betray their oaths to the Republic and side with Revan, Admiral Carith, Mon Halan, General Darid, and all the rest.
Right after that final battle at Malachor, I was right there with the rest of the defectors, because it was the right thing to do.
No, it wasn't. We needed the Jedi during the Mandalorian Wars, more than anything. The Mandalorians were slaughtering us by the millions. The millions. You were at Serico, when they turned the Starib cities into glass craters. At Duro, when basilisk war droids rained like meteors onto the orbiting cities. And when the Mandalorians set fire to the Zoxan Plains on Ares III, the fires that still burn, without the Jedi who turned on the Council, without you, the Republic would have lost the war, and we would all be Mandalorian slaves or corpses. If that's what you want to call knowing when to fight and when to kill, then yes. But you can't really break down people into Sith and Jedi and expect everything to make sense. We were loyal to Revan. That was enough. He saved us.
After Malachor, after the Mandalorian Wars, that's when the Sith teachings started spreading through the ranks.
We knew where our loyalties lay. To the Jedi who came to help us. Not the ones who sat back on Dantooine and Coruscant, watching us die.
So when those same Jedi who watched us die decided to start fighting us during the Jedi Civil War, we fought back. I fought back.
I didn't fight Jedi. I killed them. A lot of them. People say killing Jedi is hard. It's not. You just have to be smart about it. No blasters, no getting close to them, no attacking them directly when you can gun down their allies instead. There's ways of gassing them, drugging them, making them lose control, torturing them. I was really good at it.
What's worse is that killing them wasn't the best thing. Making them fall. Making them see our side of it. That was the best.
Yeah? Maybe you'll believe this. That when fighting a Jedi, you wound the Padawan first. Then let the rest take care of itself. Not only will the Master move to protect the student, but the forced bond between the two will mess up the Master's head better than any stab wound. Anything else? That's only a sample of my arsenal. If there's no whiny little Padawan, start shooting innocents. Not to kill, just enough so that they're gonna die unless the Jedi does something to save them. And if any Jedi is stupid enough to use their Makashi lightsaber form against you, start shooting as fast as you can and drop them while they're exposed. Set mines. Set a lot of them. Fire gas grenades. But make sure they have magnetic lock targeters so Jedi can't force push them back. I taught myself techniques. It's hard for Jedi to sense what you're really thinking if you throw up walls of strong emotions and feelings. Lust, impatience, cowardice. Most Jedi awareness doesn't cruise beyond the surface feelings to see what's deeper. And I was good at that, throwing up walls. And my superiors knew it. Sometimes the Jedi on our side wouldn't even realize I was there. Yeah, I had a talent for it. More like instinct. I wasn't the only one. I know you left at the Mandalorian Wars. So you don't know much about what went on behind the scenes in the Jedi Civil War. But Revan understood one thing. The real battle was going to be fought between the Jedi on both sides. That was the only battle that mattered. Whoever had the most, the strongest Jedi were going to win the Civil War. If Revan couldn't convert Jedi, Revan would kill them. So Revan trained elite Sith units into assassination squads, whose duty was to go out and capture enemy Jedi. I was in one of the special units trained to do this. Yeah, Revan had plans for all Jedi. I think it was important that the Jedi see his side of things, the Sith teachings. Revan wanted to break them, and then have them join him. One day, I decided not to do it anymore, so I left. Ended up on Nar Shaddaa, became someone else. Because you've killed Jedi too. Different circumstances, but you have a bigger body count than I ever did. And I've been with you only a short time. Enough to know that as soon as someone signs on with you, they haven't got long to live. You got history, and anyone who travels with you doesn't. And maybe I want somebody to know who I was in case a story needs to be set straight. Maybe you understand. Take your time. I have.